Facebook, hanging out with my boy Puff. That's my boy. So YouTube has given me a video posting strike for quote-unquote violating community guidelines too many times. I don't know when they'll get lifted, but my channel's still up. And I think it's horseshit, to be honest. Hot Puff. Yeah. In fact, one of my chillin' videos got flagged for hate speech. I don't promote hate speech on my channel, dude. My fucking asshole YouTube trolls love to mass flag my videos for bullshit, and it gets me in trouble with YouTube. Yet when I go to flag their shit for stealing my videos, YouTube doesn't care. Hop off. Yeah, that's my boy. So YouTube, if you don't see me posting on YouTube for a couple days, you know what's up. I'm writing to you a video recording for you on Facebook until then, I guess. Ridiculous, YouTube. Fucking ridiculous. But what do? Top poppers. That's my pop. Nothing you can do, Facebook. Just have a glass of some of this stuff and wait it out. Save the rest of that for later, like on Halloween. This apple mead that I made is delicious. Handsome lizard. You want to see how I made this apple mead? I'll post a link to it on my Facebook. Oh, sweet. Ozzy and his family got a new podcast. I want to watch that. No, it's bullshit, man. My trolls do everything in their power to try to make my life as miserable as fucking possible. And they screw with me on my jobs. They've gotten me fired from 2 jobs here in town, and it's ridiculous. Whenever I try to upload a video, it says you cannot upload a video due to multiple community guideline strikes at this moment. It's bullshit. People are dedicated to hating me, and it's just sad. I've cut down on my drinking. You know what I'm saying? And I feel good about that. Man, that's some really good wine, too. I like making my own homemade wine. Good fine afternoon, YouTube. So that mead video is about 2 weeks old. It turned out really great, so I'm not gonna lie, Facebook. I've already filtered it into another bottle, as you can see. I waited like 10 days before filtering it out into another bottle with all the caramel in it. The caramel practically dissolved. There he goes. I love my puff. He gets his exercise around the apartment. He's safer getting running around the apartment getting exercise than he is running around outside. You know. The puff's doing good. He's my favorite lizard. Ain't that right, Puff? Oh, there he goes. I had a spare Mott's apple juice gallon jug to pour it into. Well, I posted the mead recipe on my Facebook so that it is preserved. You know what? And I refuse to let the trolls get to me. Refuse. Once they realize how fucking miserable they are, like, what the fuck am I doing with my life? It'll hit them like a ton of bricks, dude. Getting the wine bottled up. I've got a lot of potential going on in my life right now, and I'm pretty happy about that. I don't understand online bullying, to be honest. I really don't. Because it requires no talent, no skills, just be an asshole. be an asshole. It requires no talent. But yeah, this apple mead turned out really delicious. And I thoroughly enjoy making it. You get better results with 100% real juice, like I did with the Mott's, 100%. Nothing you can do about it, Facebook. So for the foreseeable future, I'll be uploading my videos to my Facebook page. Just so some fucking asshole could steal it and then re-upload it to their channel. Like, I'm so sick and tired of all the copycat Cobra channels. But it is what it is. If people are stealing my videos and copying my style, then I know I'm doing something right. So even when I copy Ozzy Osbourne and Danny Filth, I kind of put my own spin on it, you know. But when I do it, it's done out of flattery and respect. My top two favorite singers right there, but that's beside the point. And, oh yeah, I got to see Cradle of Filth live. That show was so fucking good, dude. Seriously, one of the best birthday presents I've received in a hot minute. One of my fans was like, "Hey man, you want to go down to Colorado and see Cradle of Filth live?" And I'm like, "Does Ozzy Osbourne kick ass?" The answer is yes. Now I've seen Ozzy Osbourne twice, and I've seen Cradle of Filth once. And I'm like, yeah, I would definitely see them live again. They were awesome. I shouted, "Prince Andrew is a nasty wanker, and God save the Queen." Oh, I definitely fanboyed pretty hard, I'm not gonna lie, dog. I got to do my Danny Phil shriek with the man himself. And you could hear it in the crowd. It was just like, yeah. Right at the end of the show, one of the bandmates was like, "That's that guy." Now, if you check the dates on the upload these mead videos, you know what's up. This is really good apple mead. I'm saving the rest of this mead for Halloween if I can help it, because this is, fuck me, this is really good mead. Apple, caramel, cinnamon, sugar. when you're making the mead, you want to use raw and unfiltered honey if you can get it at the store. You'll get a better result, in my opinion. I haven't tried any other kind of honey, but honestly, the raw and unfiltered does it for me, man. That's the thing of it. I have fans who buy me a wood lathe because they want to see my lawns get better. I got fans who take me to see Cradle of Filth live because they know Danny Filth is one of my idols. I got fans who watch my videos religiously. The turbo yeast that my fans send me, that's the thing of it too. I just got into making my own wine, and my fans send me turbo yeast and yeast packets and wine making equipment. Because they're like, hey, Cobalt discovered a new hobby that's right up his alley, you know, making his own drink combos and such. But I'm happy with the way that wine turned out. That is exquisite. It's supposed to be like 20% ABV, alcohol by volume. I would serve that apple mead at a party, dude. That's how good that is. I gave it 10 days to ferment with the apples in it. It's already made out of 100% apple juice. But I added a whole Royal Gala apple to it. Like you saw in that video. It takes longer to make your own alcohol, so you tend to drink it a little slower. But worth every penny, dude. Really, if you want to be a famous YouTuber, you gotta focus on the fans. And stay humble no matter how famous you become. That's just my advice. And don't let the haters get to you. Even if you're not famous, people just go out of their way to bully and hate people on the internet for no fucking reason. And it's so retarded. It is beyond retarded, you Facebook. I'm allowed to say that word because I have Asperger's, but that's beside the point. That's our word. See what I did there? No. But now one of my chillin' videos got flagged for hate speech, and I was like, get the fuck out of here with that. So it is what it is. But I'll catch you later, Facebook.